I don't think this has ever been more necessary. Trooper. I know what you think of Trooper. Why your eyes closed? Because I'm sleepy. It's 11:08. My alarm started going off at 9. Bing, bing, bing. And then I was like, snooze that shit. And then it went off at 9:15. And I was like, snooze that shit again. And then my phone alarm started going off. And then my damn Alexa shit started going off again. And I was like, all right, fine, I'll get up. So at 9:30, that's an hour and a half. Only had one coffee so far. I got this coffee right here. And let's get up out of here, because I don't know why. Why did I force myself up? I should still be asleep, but I don't even know. I was just like, I'm getting up today. And I'm going to go play poker. And whatever. So let's just roll. By the way, it's Sunday. Sunday, huh? Yeah, see or no? See or no? What's all this text messages and shit that's going on? What? Okay. Well, I really thought that my second coffee and the drive to the strip would wake me up, but it doesn't appear to be so. All right, I need to wake up. Coffee didn't work. Shower didn't work. My drive to the strip didn't work. One last thing to try. Just my work. Inside the MGM Grand. No fooling around, no time to dilly-dally. Let's just get right into a game. I'm on the list. I don't even know how many games there are. I completely forgot to look at Bravo. I just came here. walked over this one time, went and checked in on the list, went back to get it. I don't believe in it, but why chance it? Plus, it's a penny. I'm a penny richer. I don't think this has ever been more necessary. I know what you think of Trooper. If you're that tired, why do you just stay in bed? I don't know. I just didn't want to. Wanted to be stubborn about... Let's see. There's something clever in here. I don't know what it is. Let me think. Something stubborn. I wanted to be stubborn about not being stubborn, or being stubborn about being stubborn. I don't know. Up for a little breaky break. Thinking about something I just saw. Thought I would tell you about it. So this hand just went down. I wasn't in the hand. To make a long story short, on the river, the board was queen 6-5 of diamonds, 5 on the turn, 8 on the river. Queen 6-5-5-8. The flop was 3 diamonds. On the river, first player to act checked. The second player bet 50 with about 130 or 40 behind. And the other player, who had almost as many chips, said, "How much do you have left?" and looked at his stack and said, "All right, I just call," and rolls over queens full. The guy who made the bet rolled over a flush. So the guy who made the bet flopped a flush. The guy who just called on the river had queens full. The second nuts. Only thing that can beat him right is quad fives. So the dude to the left of the guy with queens said, "Why didn't you raise?" And he very quickly said, "Pocket fives." The guy could have pocket fives. The dude says, "Yeah, I've had a lot of bad beats in situations like that." Now, obviously, I don't have to tell most of you how terrible that is. And how, if the guy has fives, you just go broke. With that amount of money, anyway. And I just thought of an interesting way to explain why it's so bad. Or why it's bad to just call with the queens full there. Obviously, we all know it is. I mean, this is such an obvious situation. The fact the guy didn't raise is insane. Every time someone walks up to a roulette wheel, bets on a single number and hits it, the casino takes a bad beat. A really, really bad beat. The odds of, if you walk up to a roulette wheel and you bet 17 black, the odds of you hitting that 17 are 37 to 1. There are 37 losing slots on the wheel and one winning slot. You are 37 to 1 underdog. The casino doesn't quit playing that because they took a bad beat. No, because the casino pays you 35 to 1. So they have a 5.26% edge over you no matter if you win or lose. So if the casino is smart enough to keep taking the bet even after millions of bad beats, then why wouldn't you take the bet when you have that edge? All right, I still got like an hour and a half to play. I'm up a little at the moment. Shit, am I tired and sleepy. Could not go to sleep last night.
You didn't even know that they had the monitor.
But yo, definitely glad I came out. Got to play in a good game. I win 176. And now I'm gonna go home and stream on Twitch. A little HD poker game. Have some fun. Have some Q&A action. Oh, you know what? I think on my way out, I should. A little square pizza action to get me through the rest of the evening here. I know what you think, a trooper. Just cheese? It was the best looking one they had. They had pepperoni and mushroom, but I didn't really want that one.
and they didn't have the jalapeno. Damn, that's hot as shit. Absolutely, without a doubt, the best pizza on the strip. Sirico's, the square pizza. You want to call it Sicilian? You go ahead. Call it Sicilian. I call it square pizza. When it's fresh, it's just unbeatable. I love it. Speaking of Sicilian square pizza, a few days ago I went with Gun Girl to Pizza Rock at Green Valley Ranch, and we got a Sicilian pizza. It was terrible. It was really awful. The bread was the worst dough, bread, pizza crust I've ever had. It was so light and airy. It was just terrible. I don't know if you ever tried the DiGiorno frozen deep pan. It was just like that. And I hated that shit. Had it one time. Now, Pizza Rock's not on the strip. I said best pizza on the strip. The best pizza overall, still to me, is the regular slices at Pizza Rock downtown. Unbelievable. It's a little bit different, it's a different thing. That square pizza at Sirico's at New York. If I was at home on the couch already and I was gonna go to sleep, I could eat two more of those. But I don't want to overdo it and get all lethargic and groggy and shit more than I already am. So good though, holy shit, that's good. Remember earlier when you were thinking Trooper? If you're so sleepy, why didn't you just stay home and sleep? Well, now you know. We just had an amazing day, a wonderful, great day, a day of jalapeno pretzel dogs, a day of winning at poker, a day of square pizza. Hard to beat it. I'm gonna head back home now though, because we got a little Twitch stream action to do. Look at all that overexposure action we got going. Damn, I look like a demon or something. What's up with this? Damn camera. Come on, you piece of shit. This camera sucks. I'm never buying another G7X. Look at that. It's about time. Damn. When the damn camera works properly, it works great. This is perfectly focused. I love the lighting. It's everything is great, right? But it has trouble focusing in low light. It won't focus on my face. It wants to focus on all the slot machines behind me. It's a bunch of horse shit, I tell you. Yo. Back to Casa del Trooper we go. And we're back at the crib, right where we started the day. Oh, that's gonna do it. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. I'ma see you next time.